My topic is training for excellence, lessons from the trenches. I know many of you here, perhaps even most of you, but for those who don't know me, I had the privilege of being Dr. Carr's primary assistant for the last 35 years. During the time, we developed together the microscopic approach in endodontics, using our practice as a testing ground for the ergonomic protocol we developed. And then through PERF, Dr. Carr Nonprofit Research Foundation, we trained over 1,000 endodontics and their assistants in microscopic techniques over a 15-year period, with the help of some very devoted and talented guest faculty. Through this experience, we learned what teaching method worked and which didn't work, and gained a sense for how to train clinicians and staff better. This was a trial by fire. As a skill we were teaching, although developed mostly by ourselves in our clinical practice, were not intuitive and could be fairly complex in implementation and require a lot of practice to master. It is probably significant that Dr. Carr wouldn't allow attendance at the course unless you were willing to bring your assistant. Nevertheless, courses were very popular, and we got to meet almost one-third of the practicing specialty over those 15 years, as well as almost 80% of postgraduate directors of endodontics in the United States and Canada. In addition, I traveled many foreign countries, as well as throughout the United States and Canada, both alone and with Dr. Carr, teaching the ergonomic approach with endodontics, and feel incredibly blessed to have met and gotten to know so many dedicated clinicians. We spent time at many of the postgraduate programs and got a sense for how endodontics was being taught at the postgraduate level of each institution. I had a supper through all the spaces in Dr. Carr's life, almost from the very beginning of his career. First in his office in Chula Vista, as you can see, even early in his career, Dr. Carr knew how to develop special relationships with his patients. Whatever you may think of this, the truth is that Dr. Carr has built an incredible team during his whole professional life and has done so with some success. I'm proud to have been part of those teams. Especially through the incredible PERF years. During committed communities and team is what he does. So it's been a quite a ride seeing how amazing teams are built. During this time, I managed to raise a family with two wonderful kids, keep my husband semi-happy, and have nothing but gratitude for all the gifts I have been given. This is our daughter. She is now practicing as a pediatrician in Phoenix, Arizona. My husband is a retired Navy, but still work in Northrop Grumman as a senior safety engineer in North Island, San Diego, California. And our son is in the Navy and is in school at Biloxi, Mississippi. In the time we have here, I'd like to give you the Cliff Note version of what I have observed and learned through this incredible journey. When Dr. Carr told me I had to do this in 18 minutes, I said, "Dr. Carr, that's not possible." And naturally, he said, "Joy, you can do anything." I apologize for the bullet point format, but each of these topics is a lecture unto itself, so we can deal with them only in summary. Dr. Carr taught me very early in my career that there are certain secrets or steps to master any skill. We're going to take some of this one at a time, and I'll try to give example of each one, so you have some context. The reason why I call them secret is that, in my experience, many people don't know these secrets, and therefore skill mastery eludes them. Secret one, understand the possibility. It is an absolute truism that most people don't really understand how good they can become at a skill. This is especially true when discussing how good your team can be together. Many teams are actually dysfunctional because of this. There is no vision of excellence, no true team bonding, and no real commitment of purpose. So many teams are simply transactional in their outlook. So the first hurdle to overcome is for the doctor to understand that team excellence is possible and achievable, and actually inevitable, if proper training is done as a team. When starting any kind of training, Dr. Carr always lays out where the goal is, and it's how it will be achieved. The point being, it will be achieved with the method we use. This is the kind of conversation Dr. Carr has with anyone when first training in a skill. Here, Vanessa, who has no prior dental assistant skill, on her first day of training, we tape her entire training period. So even at the beginning, Vanessa knows we have a method that ensures she will become very skillful. Understanding the possibility, that's the key.
First of all, because this is a pretty stressful job, I want you to know that I will never sit you down with a patient and expect you to do something that you haven't practiced already thousands of times, and this will reduce the stress for you tremendously. You will never have to be expected to do anything that you aren't completely comfortable doing and have practiced over and over again. And this will allow you to sit here comfortably and confidently while we treat patients.
So emphasize this point. In many ways, for a team to really coalesce, this is the hardest hurdle, to understand how good they can be simply by using our method. This is me when I was 13 years old. If you look at all the things Dr. Carr taught me, how to operate an electron microscope, not only to operate it, but to process the specimens and to image them to a very high standard, all accomplished by breaking complex procedure down into simpler ones and providing me with many small wins over a long period of time. He taught me how to do world-class photography in exactly the same way, one step at a time, breaking complex tasks into smaller steps, and even how to process and stain histological material better than the commercial labs he was using, and even learn transmission electron microscopy at a high level, a skill that can take other many years to master, all by utilizing the secrets and giving me the confidence and courage to keep getting better each day. Do you think this was in my job description? Do you think this is what I thought was possible when I first started? Believe me, your biggest hurdle is in your own mind. I know this because I have lived it. Secret 2, focus on the details. One of Dr. Carr's favorite saying is, dream big, but focus small. As you watch this video of Ingrid's, another trainee with no prior assistant skill, first attempt to learn the mirror passing skill, notice how we focus on all the little nuances of the technique, nuances one doesn't see by simply observing. One must actually do it to appreciate the minor details. After each try, demonstrate again, and Ingrid picked up another detail that was missed earlier. All training by excellence consists of this process: demonstration, practice, demonstration again, practice again, repetition. Secret 3, identify keystone habit. Whenever you are struggling with anything in life, finding the keystone habit, whether it's a thought process or a physical skill, identifying the keystone habit is what enables the breakthroughs. So what is a keystone habit? Keystone habits are habits that leads to the development of the multiple good habits. They are habits that build upon each other. Even exceptional teamwork itself is a keystone habit. What is important to realize is that keystone habits have a chain effect in your life that produces any number of positive outcomes separated from the benefit that was derived by developing the original habit. This keystone habit looks simple, but it's quite complex, with many small details that are missed by the casual observer. Once this skill is mastered, even more complex skills are possible and build upon each other. All of the skills you see demonstrated here are built one at a time, sequentially, using keystone habit. As you watch this video, there are many keystone habits being used here, one built upon the other. Secret 4, take complex tasks and break them down to smaller steps. All mastery is built slowly and incrementally by taking complex tasks, breaking them down into a simpler task. If you think about anything in your life that you have mastered, you will realize that is how you master it, by simplifying into smaller steps. As an example, for over 15 years, we taught a very complex skill, microsurgical suturing, to 100 of endodontics and their assistants, and they mastered it, breaking down into smaller steps. There are 6 defined steps to this. Many of you here learned this and learned to do it well, because we broke this down into 6 distinct steps, and you master each step individually, one at a time. Secret 5, realize small wins early. When training, realize small wins early is one of the great secrets the few people appreciate the power of. No one does things perfectly the first, second, or third time. By emphasizing the positive things done right, you encourage a person to do more things right. Small wins are exactly what they sound like and are part of how Keystone habits create widespread changes. A huge body of research has shown that small wins have enormous power and influence disproportionate to the accomplishments of victories themselves. This is just a small example of small wins on Vanessa's first training day. It seems like a small thing, but it isn't. Secret 6, repetition, repetition, repetition. Elite athletes or accomplished musicians understand this intuitively, but it bears repeating. Pardon the pun. The goal with many muscle memory skills is automaticity, and automaticity doesn't happen without hundreds of thousands of repetitions. My observations are that many endodontists don't recognize just how many repetitions are necessary before automaticity is achieved. These are the two of Dr. Carr's favorite slides, so basic yet so wise. I'm going to have you read it so you can emphasize it. So when you are training someone, keep these slides always in your mind, and if you follow it, you will become and your team will become better than you ever thought possible. I can promise you this. So to review, the process is really pretty simple. It's what we call training professionally. Explain, demonstrate, use repetition until automaticity, and review every skill every day until automaticity is achieved. When you are wanting to really go up the curve fast, this suggestion can help you immensely. One, learn the muscle memory skill first without the microscope. It makes microscope implementation far easier, smoother, and faster. Two, always have a part of training session done blindfolded. Most nuances and skill are not visual, they are tactile. Practicing blindfolded enhances and accentuated that skill. Three, always have the assistant practice as a doctor. This is a non-intuitive, but our experience is that it pays huge dividend almost immediately. And finally, go through your team working together and review the video together as a team. This is infrequently done by teams, and it's a huge mistake, and it's probably the key secret to true team bonding and mastery. There is a reason why Tom Brady spent 40 hours a week reviewing game films, yes? And now a short video of why I feel so blessed to be part of this community. Thank you very much.
I promise.